Hello everyone, I am Mrs. Sunita Dole, working as an assistant professor in Computer Science and Engineering Department of Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Topic covered here is top-down parsing. Top-down parsing can be viewed as an attempt to find a leftmost derivation for an input string. Equivalently, it can be viewed as an attempt to construct a parse tree for the input, starting from the root and creating the node of the parse tree in pre-order. In this video, I am going to introduce the basic behind the top-down parsing and show how to construct an efficient non-backtracking form of the top-down parser called predictive parser. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to identify the recursive descent parser and parse the string using the predictive parsing. In top-down parser, the parse tree is created top to bottom. Following are the examples of the top-down parser: recursive descent parser, predictive parser, and the non-recursive predictive parser. In this video, I am going to cover the recursive descent parser and the predictive parser. Recursive descent parser. Backtracking is needed, that is, if a choice of a production rule does not work, we backtrack to try other alternatives. It tries to find the leftmost derivation. It is the general parsing technique but not widely used. Example: S derives CAD, A derives AB or A, and the input string is W is equal to CAD. To construct a parse tree for this string top down, we initially create a tree consisting of a single node labeled S. An input pointer points to C, the first symbol of W. So we use the first production for S to expand the tree and obtain the tree of figure A. The leftmost leaf labeled C matches the first symbol of W, so we now advance the input pointer to A, the second symbol of W, and consider the next leaf labeled A. We can then expand the A using the first alternative for A to obtain the tree of figure B. We now have a match for the second input symbol, so we advance the input pointer to D, the third symbol of the input, and compare D against the next leaf labeled B. Since B does not match D, we report failure and go back to see whether there is another alternative for A that we have not tried but that might produce a match. In going back to A, we must store the input pointer in a local variable. We now try the second alternative for A to obtain the tree of figure C. The leaf A matches the second symbol of W and the leaf D matches the third symbol. Since we have produced a parse tree for W, we halt and announce the successful completion of the parsing. Till now, we consider the top-down parser, recursive descent parser. Now pause this video and reflect on this question for a minute or 2 minutes and write your response. Once you return the answer to these questions, then you can restart playing this video. The question is, construct a recursive descent parser with backtracking for the grammar. I hope all of you have completed this activity. So the question was, construct a recursive descent parser with backtracking for the grammar. S derives ASBS, BSAS or epsilon, and the input string W is equal to ABAB. To construct a parse tree for this string top down, we initially create a tree consisting of single node labeled S. An input pointer points to A, the first symbol of W. We then use the first production for S to expand the tree and obtain the tree of figure A. The leftmost leaf labeled A matches the first symbol of W, so we now advance the input pointer to B, the second symbol of W, and consider the next leaf labeled S. We can then expand S using the first alternative for S, that is S derives ASBS to obtain the tree of figure B. In input string, second input symbol is B. So compare B against the next leaf labeled A. Since A does not match with B, we report the failure and go back to see whether there is another alternative for S that we have not tried but that might produce the match. In going back to S, we must store the input pointer in a local variable. We now try the second alternative for S to obtain the tree of figure C. The leaf B matches the second symbol of B. We repeat the same procedure for the second and third symbol of the input string W, and we can produce a parse tree as shown in figure D. So we halt and announce the successful completion of parsing. Predictive parser. In many cases, by carefully writing a grammar, eliminating left recursion from it, and left factoring the resulting grammar, we can obtain a grammar that can be parsed by a recursive descent parser that needs no backtracking, that is a predictive parser. To construct a predictive parser, we must know, given the current input symbol A and the non-terminal A to be expanded, which one of the alternative of the production A derives alpha 1 or alpha 2 and so on up to alpha k is the unique alternative that derives a string beginning with A. That is, the proper alternative must be detectable by looking at only the first symbol it derives. Flow of control construct in most programming language with their distinguishing keywords are usually detectable in this way. For example, if we have the following production statement derives if expression then statement else statement, or while expression do statement, or begin statement list end, then the keyword if, while and begin tell us which alternative is the only one that could possibly succeed if we are to find a statement. Transition diagram for the predictive parser. In parser, there is one diagram for each non-terminal. The label of edges are token and non-terminals. A transition on a token means we should take that transition if that token is the next input symbol. If a transition on non-terminal A is a call of procedure for A. To construct a transition diagram of a predictive parser from a grammar, first eliminate the left recursion from the grammar and then left factor the grammar. Then, for each non-terminal A, do the following. Create an initial and final state. For each production A derives x1, x2 up to xn, create a path from the initial top, the final state, with the edges x1, x2 up to xn. Predictive parser behaves as follows. It begins in the start state from the start symbol. If after some action, it is in state S with an edge labeled by a terminal A to the state T, and if the next input symbol is A, then the parser moves the input cursor one position right and goes to the state T. If an edge is labeled by a non-terminal A, then parser goes to the start state for A without moving the input cursor. If it ever reaches the final state for A, it immediately goes back to the state T, in effect having read A from the input during the time it moved from state S to state T. If there is an edge from S to T labeled epsilon, then from the state S, the parser immediately goes to the state without advancing the input. A predictive parser program based on the transition diagram attempts to match the terminal symbol against the input and makes a potential recursive procedure call whenever it has to follow an edge labeled by a non-terminal. Figure contains a transition diagram for a given grammar. The only ambiguity is concern whether or not to take an epsilon edge. If we interpret the edge out of the initial state for E dash as saying take the transition on plus whenever, that is the next input, and take the transition on epsilon otherwise, and make the analogous assumption for t dash, then the ambiguity is removed. And we can write a predictive passing program for the grammar. Transition diagram can be simplified by substituting the diagrams in one another. For example, in figure A, the call of the E dash on itself has been replaced by a jump to the beginning of the diagram for E dash. Figure B shows an equivalent transition diagram for E dash. We may then substitute the diagram of figure B for the transition on E dash in the transition diagram for E, yielding the diagram of figure C. Observe that the first and the third node in the figure C are equivalent, and we merge them, resulting in figure D. The same technique applies to the diagram for T and the T dash. The complete set of resulting diagram is shown in the following figure. Now, how to pass the input string using the predictive parser? Here, the input string is ID plus ID. Step 1. First input symbol is ID, hence the input cursor points to ID. So consider the first transition diagram, that is for the non-terminal E. There is a transition from 0 to 3 on the non-terminal T. So parser goes to the start state for the T without moving the input cursor. In transition diagram for T, there is a transition from state 7 to 8 on the non-terminal F. So the parser goes to the start state for F without moving the input cursor. In the transition diagram for F, there is a state 14 with an edge labeled by a terminal ID to the state 17, and the input symbol is also ID, so the parser moves the input cursor to the next input symbol plus and goes to the final state 17. Now parser goes back from the state 17 to 8 and from 8 to the final state 13 on input symbol epsilon. From the state 13, parser goes back to the 3. Step 2. Now input cursor is pointing to plus, hence parser goes from the state 3 to 0 on the input symbol plus. Now the parser moves the input cursor to the next input symbol ID. Step 3. Parser repeats the step 1 for the input symbol ID and finally goes to the final state 6 from the state 3 on epsilon. This is the reference. Thank you.